Hi, this is John Keller. This is a quick review of how to do part two of the Using Quantum Theory to Explore Molecular Structure and Bonding experiment. In this part, we will use VSEPR to predict the geometry of a molecule, then compare this geometry to one optimized with Gaussian, an advanced quantum theory program. Hydroxycarbene, HCOH, is a linear, i.e. not branched, molecule. It contains 12 valence electrons, as indicated by the formula. First, connect the atoms with single bonds, each of which contains two electrons. So we have 6 electrons left, which will then be added in pairs. We'll put 4 on oxygen and 2 on carbon. This gives oxygen an octet, but leaves carbon with only 6. Since we cannot add more electrons, 2 from oxygen must be moved into a second carbon-oxygen bond. Now both atoms have octets. It turns out calculations are easier to set up if any non-zero formal charges are included. The formal charge equals the number of valence electrons in the free atom minus the number surrounding the atom in the Lewis formula. Carbon is 4, minus 2 for the lone pair, and 3 for half the bonding electrons to carbon, or minus 1. Likewise, oxygen is plus 1. Okay, now predicting geometry with VSEPR. Both atoms have trigonal electron pair geometry and one lone pair. That gives the bent molecular geometry with a nominal bond angle of 120 degrees. UAF's copy of Gaussian is accessed through the WebMO webpage. Log in by clicking the MO graphic and entering your UAF username and password. Do New Job, Create New Job. Now use the Build tool to draw a copy of the Lewis formula. Put in a formal charge by right-clicking the atom and entering the charge in the Edit Charge box. Now do Cleanup, Comprehensive, Idealized. Here WebMO uses VSEPR rules to build an approximate structure, which is a starting point for geometry optimization. As expected, the bond angles are 120 degrees. Enter an informative job name. Choose Geometry Optimization, and keep the default theory and basis set. Charge is 0 for a molecule. Now submit the job. When the job is complete, click the job name. So, hydroxycarbene is indeed planar, and the atoms look roughly trigonal. However, the HOC angle is only 107.9 degrees, and the OCH angle is 101.3 degrees. Also, the OC bond length is 1.32 angstroms. This value is actually somewhere between the standard CO single and double bond values. The bond angles are less than those predicted by VSEPR, which would be explained in the VSEPR world by postulating large lone pair electron densities that push back the other bonds. Following this line of reasoning, one might even guess that because the OCH bond angle is less, the carbon lone pair is larger than the oxygen lone pair. That rationale might be something one could include in the report in part 2, plus a cartoon representation. It turns out that the orbital picture of hydroxycarbene, although it's derived from the very different Schrödinger equation and not VSEPR theory, shows a similar picture. These hydroxycarbene orbitals were calculated with Gaussian and plotted using JMOL, a molecular graphics program. Carbon lone pair is slightly larger than the oxygen lone pair, which is consistent with the different bond angles in the optimized structure. The end.